This series of instructional videos will help you to understand some of the basics of the collection process that we use. In the lab, we implement a number of methods to evaluate the brain and its underlying neurophysiology. Today, we will be learning a little bit about electroencephalography, also known as EEG. EEG measures the summation of electrical activity on the scalp, primarily derived from postsynaptic activity around the dendrites of pyramidal neurons in the cerebral cortex. Neurons communicate by passing an electrical signal by the movement of ions flowing in and out of the cell. First, electrical signals are transmitted from the dendrites to the cell membrane where they meet the axon hillock. Here, the summation of all these charges is used by the axon hillock, which is the gatekeeper of the neuron, to decide whether or not the signal should be passed on to the axon terminal. The axon hillock is the point where the summation of excitatory postsynaptic potentials and inhibitory postsynaptic potentials meet. If the summation of these potentials reaches the threshold, the signal passes. The neuron has a resting membrane potential of about negative 70 millivolts. Voltage-gated sodium channels will open when the membrane potential becomes more positive or depolarizes. When this occurs, the sodium rushes into the cell, transmitting the depolarization down the axon. This occurrence is called an action potential. However, a single electrical event isn't big enough to be detected by EEG, and action potentials can cancel each other out. Enter the pyramidal neuron. Pyramidal neurons are found in the most superficial layers of the brain and are spatially aligned. Thus, their activity is synchronous, which produces a larger signal that can be measured superficially from the scalp. Axons from neighboring neurons synapse with the pyramidal neurons. Chemically gated ions on the postsynaptic membrane open in response to increased concentration of neurotransmitters that bind to the proteins. However, when the depolarization begins at one end of the neuron, the other end repolarizes back to negative 70 millivolts, thus creating a dipole of the neuron and conducting a current. It is important to remember that regardless of whether an action potential is reached or not, all postsynaptic potentials will contribute to the EEG signal. Every postsynaptic potential causes the charge inside the neuron to change and the charge outside the neuron to change in opposition. The summation of the dipoles created by hundreds to thousands of neurons is what is detected by the EEG. Hopefully this video gave you an introduction to EEG methods and how they work. Thanks for watching.